Hey guys, it's Brie. So today I'm going to be talking to you about sex, contraception and pregnancy. These are three things I think need to be talked about a lot more, especially in our sexual education systems that we have in our schools. Now obviously I only know about the schools over here that we have in the UK, I'm not sure about America, but I think even your schools over there and the rest of the world really need to update their sexual education systems. So the first thing is contraception. There are a number of different contraceptions, and as the name suggests, they're there to stop you getting pregnant. However, I think what a lot of girls don't realise is actually every single one of them can fail and has a failure rate. I have seen everything during this job because obviously I talk about periods and stuff that is also linked to sex and pregnancy and giving birth and all that sort of stuff. So I see this on a daily basis basically. And I have seen every single method fail. Everything from the pill and condoms right up to vasectomies and even a hysterectomy I've seen fail once. That was a unique case. She happened to have two uteruses, but you never know if it could be you. And the doctors didn't notice she had it anyway. But she did get pregnant after she'd had a hysterectomy, which was quite amazing. But yeah, I've seen every single method fail. And after seeing that, I've realised actually a lot of girls really need to take this into account a lot more when they're thinking about having sex and also who they're having sex with. So when it comes to actually having sex, I don't really have any experience in this department at all, but like I said, I speak to girls on a regular basis who do have sex, who take the pill or use condoms or whatever method of contraception they've gone for and have had it fail. And the number of times, usually with the pill actually, that I've seen girls come to me and have said, I've taken the pill every single day, you know, I haven't been sick or anything, and I think I could be pregnant because my period's late. And I go to them, yep, you could be. And then they go, why? And that's the point where I just want to hit my head against the wall, because the answer is, the pill doesn't work for everyone, it has a failure rate, and your body can choose to reject the hormone you're taking. Now there are several different types of the pill, but one of them works, and the one I know the most about, is the one that you take and which tricks your body into thinking you're pregnant. Now this pill happens to stop you from ovulating. However, if you take the pill every single day, no matter what, and your body rejects it, what's going to happen is that you haven't accepted the hormone, your body hasn't been tricked into thinking you're pregnant, and you're going to ovulate. As soon as you ovulate, you've got an egg, you have sex, sperm joins the egg, there's a baby. Simple as. Now with condoms it's a little more obvious as to why they can fail and stuff, you know, they can tear, but you don't always notice if they tear, and that's another thing to bear in mind when you're using condoms. It's usually to use two different types of contraceptives together, so a lot of people take the pill and use condoms, and some people use a diaphragm and take the pill or whatever. Often when you're younger they will combine two different methods of contraception to try and make sure they don't get pregnant. But the moral of the story is, if you're having sex, you can get pregnant. No ifs, ands or buts, that is the bottom line. So when you're having sex, you have got to realise that you willingly accept this fact. There is no such thing as an accidental pregnancy. For the moment, exclude rape. I know that's a completely different situation, it's a lot harder to deal with, but presuming you willingly choose to have sex, you willingly also accept the fact that you can get pregnant. There, and as I said before, there's no ifs or maybes about it, you do. So when people get pregnant and they're surprised, it really does make me, as I said before, want to hit my head against a wall, because I just think, you had sex, you willingly accepted the fact that this could happen. Maybe consciously in your brain you didn't, but your body accepted it, because that is what penetrative sex is for, obviously. Now, pregnancy isn't a risk for people who are gay, for example, but, you know, you still have to bear in mind that there are STIs and different things that you can get, no matter whether you're straight or gay or whatever. You know, it's just, the risks are always there. Now, I'm not saying you should all wait for marriage or wait till you're in, like, a super stable relationship before you should have sex, but I am saying that you guys should really think about it, especially girls who are my age. I'm 17. We should really think about it a lot more, because, you know, it's very difficult for people who are our age to come to terms with the fact that they're pregnant. The one thing you have got to think about, I think, the most when you're deciding whether or not to have sex, if you're at the point where you're thinking, I think I'm ready. The other thing you should bear in mind is take into account the question, I'm ready to have sex, but am I ready to have a baby? And I'm not saying when I say this that you should be at the point in your life when you've, like, when you've just decided, you know, like, right, now I think it's the time to have my kids, I should do that. I'm not saying that. I'm just saying that if it happened, are you at a point where you could cope with it financially and physically and emotionally and mentally and all that kind of stuff? Because that's the question you should really take into account. For some people who have sex, probably think, you know, now's not the most ideal time for me to get pregnant, but you know what, if it happened, I could cope and I could deal with it very easily. And I think well, for pretty much every teenager who's my age, that is not something that we are prepared for. You know, it happens, but we're not actually in the point where we could really deal with it. We have to rely on other people around us to help us. And that's not really fair on the child, I don't think. The other thing I want to point out is I'm not saying in this video by any means that teen mums are bad. I think a lot of them are very good mums, and age has nothing to do with it. It's your level of maturity, whether you think you're ready or not, and that is different for everyone. And whatever you decide is your decision, and everyone else should respect that. If they don't, then they clearly aren't good friends of yours. And the other thing I think girls are a bit afraid of is the fact that if they say to guys that they're not having sex or they're not ready to have sex, the guys are going to leave them. That is just not the case, and I mean, it is sometimes the case, but it's not the case with every single guy, and if they do leave you for that, they really don't deserve you. It's as simple as that. But there are guys out there who will wait, and they should respect that it's your decision, and you should respect theirs as well. That's another thing to mention. We always presume that girls are the ones who make these decisions, but guys do as well. So, you know, whatever happens, respect you and your partner. You should respect your partner's decision, and they should respect yours. So I hope that this video made you girls think, girls or guys, I guess, you could both be watching this, but I hope it did make you think and realise actually there's more to it when you're having sex than just doing the deed. You know, there's other things that are linked in here and other complications that you do really in this day and age need to think about. We're not back in the caveman years when we could do whatever we wanted practically. But thanks for watching, guys. Please subscribe because I make videos every Monday, Wednesday and Friday, and I will talk to you later. Bye-bye.